Well, just a few hours ago, the man accused of killing a youth baseball coach on Highway 169 took the stand in his own defense.
Jamal Smith denied shooting Jay Bouton and instead pointed the finger at one of his passengers. Lou Ragusa was in the courtroom for that testimony and joins us live now from the courthouse with more. Lou?
Jamal Smith testified that he didn't even see Jay Bouton's truck that night and that he didn't realize the loud boom he heard was a gunshot. Then the prosecution aggressively cross-examined Smith on his story. After 32 witnesses testified against him in his murder trial, Jamal Smith took the witness stand himself. He told the jury he felt like an idiot seeing his Facebook video played in court in which he points a gun at the camera hours before Jay Bouton was killed while driving next to him on Highway 169. Smith testified that he heard a loud boom after his backseat passenger rolled down the window. "What did you think that loud boom was?" Smith's lawyer asked. "It kind of shell-shocked me. I really didn't know what it was. We drove through a storm. Thunder?" Under cross-examination, when directly asked by the prosecution, Smith specified that he claims his backseat passenger shot. With an incredulous tone, prosecutor Dan Allard asked, "A 45 caliber gun fired in this confined space and you didn't know what made the boom?" Smith: "It could have been thunder. It could have been a gunshot. I could have been shot." The prosecution rested its case this morning after calling a jail guard who testified that Smith said to him, "Do you even know who I am? I'm a nationwide murderer. Go ahead and put that down. I'm a murderer." Now, this case is difficult for the jury because of that question of who within that SUV fired the shot. The prosecution's case consists of a lot of things that point to Smith, at the very least, as the most likely shooter. Whether it's beyond a reasonable doubt, that's the question. And it's difficult to say if Smith's testimony helped himself in any way because the prosecution was able to poke a lot of holes in his story. But if the jury does believe his story, he told it in such a way that would absolve himself from the aiding and abetting in the shooting. One last thing to mention, though, today he did admit to having a firearm illegally. That's something he's charged with as well, which is looking like he basically admitted to it in the course of his testimony today. Back to you.
Wow, riveting testimony today. Thank you, Lou.